أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear student, I am Dr. Azhar Ali. Today, I am going to present the first lecture of first week for the course Applied Mathematics 2. My first topic is Introduction to Ordinary Differential Equations. This course is offered for the second semester of BC Electrical and Mechanical Engineering students. Before starting up my lecture, first of all, I would like to give some idea about the objective of the course. The main purposes of this course is to present different methods of finding solution to differential equation and to discuss properties of its solution. To provide a framework for this discussion, in this section we give several ways of classifying first order differential equation. Now let me tell you about the contents of this course. In this course we will discuss different types of ordinary differential equations like first order differential equations and higher order differential equations. In the first order differential equation we will discuss two types, linear differential equations and nonlinear differential equations. In the nonlinear first order differential equation we will discuss five types of differential equation like separation of variables, separable differential equations, homogeneous differential equation, exact differential equation, linear differential equation and Bernoulli differential equations. For the higher differential equation we will discuss a linear differential equation of higher order and the linear differential equation of higher order. In this case we will discuss two types, homogeneous differential equations and non-homogeneous differential equations. Dear students, I have already uploaded the course contents at SUDE portal. You can download the course outline from the SUDE portal. Now I would like to start my first lecture from the definition of differential equation. What is a differential equation? An equation involving an unknown function and its derivative is called a differential equation. In any equation, if the differential operator is appear, then the equation will be called a differential equation. For example, dy by dx. This is the derivative of unknown function y with respect to x. So, in any equation, when we see the operator dy by dx, then the differential equation will be called a differential equation. Ordinary differential equation. A differential equation involving only the ordinary derivatives of one or more dependent variables with respect to a single independent variable is called ordinary differential equation. Partial differential equation. A differential equation involving partial derivatives of one or more dependent variables with respect to two or more independent variables is called partial differential equation. Here, the main difference between the ordinary differential equation and the partial differential equation is that in the ordinary differential equation we take derivative of one or more dependent variable with respect to a single independent variable, but in the partial differential equation we take derivative of one or more dependent variable with respect to two, not a single, with respect to two or more independent variables. So this is the difference between the ordinary differential equation and partial differential equation. Now what is the order of differential equation? Order of the differential equation is the order of the highest derivative appearing in the differential equation is called order of the differential equation. Degree of differential equation. Degree of the differential equation is the power of highest derivative appearing in the differential equation. Now there are two types of solution of differential equation. One type is a particular solution. Particular solution of a differential equation is any one solution. But the general solution of the differential equation is a set of all solutions. Now, what is the terminology of the differential equation? Before solving a differential equation, dear student, first of all, check the terminology of the differential equation, and in the terminology, first check the existence of the solution. That does a differential equation have a solution? Then check the uniqueness of the solution. Does a differential equation have more than one solution? If yes, then how can we find a solution which satisfied particular conditions? The third terminology is that does a differential equation have initial condition? If the differential equation have initial condition, then the equation called initial value problem. In short, we can write IVP, initial value problem. Or does the differential equation have boundary value problem, have boundary condition? If the differential equation have boundary condition, then it's called boundary value problem. In short, we write BVP, boundary value problem. Dear student, what is the initial value problem and boundary value problem? Inshallah, in the next coming slides, I will tell you about the initial value problem and boundary value problem. Now, this is the fourth terminology. If no initial condition are given, we call the description of all solutions to the differential equation the general solution. It means that if there is no condition given, then the solution will be general solution. Now you see here, this is the first order differential equation. Y dash mean the derivative of y with respect to this independent variable x dy by dx. We can classify this first order differential equation into two types, nonlinear and linear differential equation of first order and nonlinear differential equation of first order. In the coming lecture, I will tell you about the linear differential equation. Here we discuss the first order nonlinear differential equation. So if the first order differential equation is nonlinear, then we can classify this equation in this form. First of all, check whether the first order nonlinear differential equation is in separable form. Check whether the differential equation is homogeneous. Check whether the differential equation is exact. Sometime the differential equation will be non-homogeneous. Then we transform the non-homogeneous differential equation into this homogeneous form and then solve by separation of variable. Similarly, sometime the differential equation will be not exact, then we transform the differential equation to the exact form by multiplying an integral factor. Now again we discuss these types, these classification of first order nonlinear differential equation and its solution of first order differential equation. Important forms of methods through which we can know the form of equation and then use or apply the method which is required. The first classification of non-homogeneous differential equation is a separable differential equation, homogeneous equation, exact equation, linear equation and Bernoulli equation. If we classify the differential equation into these form, then we can solve easily, because there is different methods for each class for the solution of differential equation. Now this is the first class, separation of variable, separable differential equation. For the solution procedure of separable differential equation, here first of all, for example, There are a differential equation of first order dy by dx is equal to g of x is equal to h of y. First of all, write the differential equation in this form. Then by cross multiplication, we separate the terms. By separation of variable means to shift the function of y to the operator dy and shift the function of x to dx. One point here is important to note that the operator dy or dx not will be in the denominator form. So after cross multiplication, rewrite as h function of y dy is equal to g function of x dx. So here you see that separation of variable is possible. Function of y joined with the operator dy and function of x with joined with the operation with the operator dx. After separation of variable, taking integration and solve the equation for y. When we solve this differential equation and integrating, then we obtain an integrating constant c. If the initial condition are given, then using that initial condition to find the value of c. For example, for separation of variable, there is a simple example. This is example number one for this class. Or differential equation of first order, the general form of differential equation will be m dx plus n dy. M is the function of x and y, also n is the function of x and y, but we try to join the function of x with the operator dx and join the function of y with the operator dy for separation of variable. For example, this is a first order differential equation xy dx minus x square dy is equal to 0. First we try to solve this differential equation by separation of variable. For the separation of variable, shift this term x square dy to the right hand side and then dividing these two terms by x square y, we get 1 over x dx is equal to 1 over y dy. So separation of variable is possible. The function of x joined with the operator dx and the function of y joined with the operator dy. So taking integrating, we get the integration of 1 over y is log y and the integration of 1 over x log x plus c. This is the solution of this differential equation. Now example number 2, a very simple example to solve this differential equation. Dy divided by dx is equal to x divided by 3y square. For the separation of variable, simply shift the 3y square term to the operator dy and shift dx to the term x. So separation of variable is possible. Mean the function of y joined with the operator dy and the function of x joined with the operator dx. Now by taking integrating, we get integration of y square is a y cube. On the fundamental process of integration, adding 1 to the power above, in adding 1 to the power in the denominator, we get y cube divided by 3, but 3 cancel. So y cube is equal to x square divided by 2 plus c. This is the result of this first order nonlinear differential equation. Now example number 3 is also a very simple example. To solve this differential equation, dy by dx is equal to minus 1 over 2x. For the separation of variable, simply shift this term dx to the right hand side. We can easily separate the variable and we get dy is equal to minus 1 over 2x. So separation of variable possible, and taking integration, after integration we get the result y is equal to minus 1 over 2 integration of 1 over x log x plus c. Now example number 4, how to solve this differential equation by separation of variable. For the separation of variable, here again try to join the same function operators of x with the operator dx in the function of y joined to the operator dy. So this dx again shift to the right hand side and this y shift to the left hand side simply by cross multiplication. By cross multiplication we get minus y dy is equal to 2x dx. And so here separation of variable is possible. Now taking integration, we get integration of 2x is equal to x square. Integration of x is x square divided by 2, but 2 to cancel, and integration of y is y square by 2 is equal to c. Multiplying both sides by 2, we get 2x square plus y square is equal to 2c. Now initial value problem and boundary value problem. A boundary value problems are similar to initial value problems. A boundary value problem has conditions specified at the extremes boundaries of the independent variables in the equation, whereas an initial value problem has all of the conditions specified at the same value of the independent variable, and that value is at the lower boundary of the domain. Thus the term initial value. For example, if the independent variable is the time over the domain 0 up to 1, a boundary value problem would specify values for at both. But initial value problem would specify a value of t is equal to a value at t is equal to 0. This is example number 5, and this is an initial value problem. So dy by dx is equal to minus y square divided by x, and the condition is given that for all x greater than 0, with the initial condition x naught is equal to 1 and y naught is equal to 1 over 3. First of all, to solve this equation by separation of variable, then in the solution we use this initial condition for the purpose to find the value of c. So to solve this differential equation, dy by dx is equal to minus y square divided by x, simply by cross multiplication, and after cross multiplication, after simplification, we get dy divided by minus y square is equal to dx divided by x. Now shift this y square term to the numerator, we get minus y power minus 2 dy 1 over x dx. Separation of variable is possible. Now taking integration of y power minus 2 and integration of 1 over x. Integration of y power minus 2 is equal to 1 over y, and integration of 1 over x is equal to natural log of x plus c. Now using this initial condition into this solution, we get the value of c as, putting value of y is equal to 1 over 3 and value of x is equal to 0. So value of c is equal to 3. Now putting this value of c in this solution, we get a particular solution, y is equal to 1 over natural log of x plus 3. Dear student, note that this solution is a general solution, but when we specify the value of c, then the solution will be a particular solution. Now application of ordinary differential equation. The application of ordinary differential equation is a modeling with first order differential equation like Newton's law of cooling electric circuits and modeling free mechanical oscillation like no damping, light damping and heavy damping. Modeling force mechanical isolations and computer exercise or activity. Dear student, in this lecture we discussed the introduction of differential equation and the classification of first order nonlinear differential equation in all the classes. Here we discussed in this lecture only the separable differential equation. Inshallah, in the next lecture we discuss the second type of first order nonlinear differential equation, which is homogeneous differential equation. Thank you for watching video.